Welcome to Reality Creative Video. Today, we're going to talk about drinking water. The reason we're going to talk about drinking water is my brother came by for a visit. And, you know, in the course of things we're talking about, he mentioned he's drinking RO water. I was like, I've done specials videos on the various kinds of water. And one of the things that I kind of tell you guys is distilled water and RO water is not for drinking. Let me tell you about the story of RO water. Because you go online and they tell you, crystal clear, beautiful tasting water. But what they leave out is the fact that RO water and distilled water is devoid of anything in it. And so it acts as a leech. When you drink RO distilled water, it leaches nutrients out of your body. And even if you're taking vitamins and minerals, it will take all of those vitamins and minerals out of your body and you will get none of it. RO water was originally designed for the lab. Now, you know, we got a lab here, you know. In lab, we've had to, you know, in labs, all across the country, distilled water is necessary for all of the chemical processes that they're doing. But the other thing they use distilled water for is, they need clean water for, is cleaning the beakers. They have to be washed. They can't be washed in tap water. Well, they can be originally washed in tap water, but they have to be rinsed with, before RO water, they had to be rinsed with distilled water. So then, I don't quote me on it, but I think it was GE that invented RO water, a membrane that separates, can do very quickly, can make a lot of water, roughly around anywhere between 2 and 8 parts per million water. And they sold it to the labs. And the labs loved it because they could use their distilled water for their experiments, and which was, you know, distilled water is costly to make. And they could use the RO water to clean their beakers and things like that. So, when you clean a beaker with RO water, like what I do is I use this Dawn dishwashing detergent, okay, in the beaker. And then I will rinse it with tap water. And then, you know, it's all sudsy is left. And normally you'd have to rinse it about 6 or 7 times to get all those suds out. All I got to do now is just take the RO water and swish the RO water on in here, dump it out, and guess what? All the soap is gone. Why is all the soap gone? Because the RO water, not having anything in it, absorbs the soap, acts as a giant sponge, and all the soap is gone, and I got a squeaky clean beaker left. Guess what it does to the inside of your body, huh? So, you can't drink distilled water and RO water. And then my brother, he comes to me, he says, well, what am I supposed to do? We got well water. It tastes horrible. We just can't keep drinking spring water or, you know, bottled water all day long. So we drink the RO water. And it's a valid question. I mean, here's your choice. Do you drink the horrible tap water that you have, or do you drink the RO water, which tastes really, really great, but, you know, it has that hidden problem in it. Eventually, you know, you will have major problems if you drink in RO water for a long period of time. It's good for short periods, like a week or two, if you want to detox your body and get rid of all of the crap that's in it. It's also going to get rid of the good stuff, but the crap will go. But that's about it. Long-term use of RO water or distilled water drinking is not good. So what can you do? Well, this is a zero water pitcher. This is almost the same as RO and distilled water. This produces 1 or 2 parts per million water. No good at all for drinking. Okay, and this is tap water. This is my well tap water, okay? Which I have mixed, all right? I've mixed the well water with the zero water. Okay, my well water, you know, comes in at about 150 parts per million. That's normal for well water. Well water can be anywhere from 300 to 150 parts per million. And what I do is I put my well water through a carbon filter. There are various carbon filters out there. You can buy them. They make pitchers like this. They look like the zero water filter, but they're just carbon filters. And the carbon filter will strip out all of the stinky stuff and the phosphates and any of the chemicals that are in your drinking water. So first you take your tap water, put it through some kind of carbon filter. If you got a refrigerator and it's got one of those, you know, screw filters built into it, that will strip out, that has a carbon filtration in it, and you could use that water from your refrigerator. As long as, you don't do like I did, and I put my RO unit to the back of the refrigerator, in which case, because I wanted to have really cool, clear ice cubes, you know, not ice cubes that were stinky from the tap water, so I used RO water. So my refrigerator, I cannot use the water from my refrigerator because it's RO water. It's fine in ice cubes. You can take RO ice cubes and dump them in whatever you're drinking, because whatever you're drinking is loaded with minerals, whatever it happens to be. If it's tea or Coke, soda or whatever, it's loaded with minerals. So the little bit of distilled water that's in the ice that's going to melt is not going to harm you. So you need to take your tap water, put it through some sort of carbon filtration. And that's what I have. I have a microlite. It's called a microlite filter. It's a water ionizer. It's an expensive unit. But the thing is, it's got a carbon filter in there. But you can just buy on Amazon regular pitchers with carbon filters in them, and that would be fine. So you put your tap water through a carbon filter, and then you mix it 50% RO or zero water with your carbon filtered water, and you will get spring water. Spring water is about 50 parts per million. And that's what I drink here, what I consider spring water. I put this in here and I'm getting 55 parts per million. So now the red, don't worry about the red color. The reason it's red is it's telling me that this is a meter to test distilled water. So the red is telling me it's no good for distilled water. So I already know that. But for drinking, 50 parts per million is fine. 100 parts per million is fine for drinking. When you get up around 200 parts per million, now you can. This is a TDS meter. You can pick them up on Amazon for about $15 to test your TDS of your water, your tap water. So if it's over 200 parts per million, that's like heavy mineralized water. Not going to kill you, but probably going to have a very strong taste to it. You may want to look into a carbon filtration system, not a zero water system, but a carbon filtration system, and then create the spring water like I have here. And incidentally, the spring water works in your hydrogen generator. This is a hydrogen generator, okay? And if you've watched my hydrogen generator shows, you push the little button and the little bubbles coming out here is creating hydrogen. And hydrogen water is actually wonderful to drink. Gives you lots of energy and stuff like that. Anyway, you can't use distilled water or RO water on hydrogen water. It doesn't work. But it works very well on spring water. This water in here is this 55 parts per million spring water that I've created from mixing my tap water and the zero water. And I get 1.5 parts per million hydrogen water in there that I can drink. So that is what I would recommend for all of you to solve your water problems. If you're drinking distilled water or tap water, please stop right away. Now, you can mix your distilled water or RO water with other things, but you have to, I have that emergency drink that I showed in the last video that I make for myself. You could mix your RO water with the emergency, because it's going to load it with vitamin C and B vitamins, and then you're not going to be drinking distilled water anymore or RO water, you know, water that has nothing in it. So it will actually put stuff back into your body. But you have to mix it with something, and it has to, you know, be substantial. You just can't put, you know, flavored water in there and think, oh, I'm putting the minerals back in. No, you have to kind of put something substantial in there. Tea. You can, RO water and distilled water makes a great tea, because the tea leaves saturate the RO and the distilled water with nutrients, and so they're not going to leach anything out of you. So we may make a cold tea if you want a cold drink with RO or distilled water. That's something else you could do with it if you can't get away from having to drink your RO water. But please do not drink just straight RO water, because you're looking for trouble. You're going to have all sorts of weird problems in your body at first. Then you're going to have major energy, major vitamin deficiency problems in your body as you continue. You might get away with drinking it for a year and not have anything. But then after that, as your body's nutrients are kind of totally exhausted, I wouldn't drink RO water for more than 2 weeks. After that, you're going into the danger zone. So that is my suggestion with water. So take it or leave it from my laboratory here. I'm Hermes. This is Reality Creator Video, and I will talk to you again soon.